Well, hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to another fantastic episode of Let's Play LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga. Today we are continuing and finalizing the storyline events here from Attack of the Clones. If you followed us in the last episode, we sort of had the spark of what I would call is the war that starts the actual Attack of the Clones war, the Clone Wars. So that was the spark of events here on Geonosis, and now we are wrapping it up, going after Count Dooku himself with Anakin and Obi-Wan, hopefully to seal the deal here and get some closure here. Of course, this is our first interaction with clone troopers, which, you know what, because we do have some things that we have to do, some world building here, I was going to save this for its own episode. I believe by the time that this has come out, hopefully I've already done it, but I want to make how Average Joe would improve upon this series, the original trilogy, right? Not the OG trilogy that was published, but the prequel trilogy, how Average Joe would rewrite it. And I want to do one episode per, you know, like once we finish all of the episode 1 levels, that comes out. Once we finish all the episode 2 levels, that comes out. That's my plan here for the longest time. Hopefully the episode 1 is already out. I'm hoping it already came out a while ago. But, you know, things could take time here on the channel. But with that being said, I have something written up here for episode 2, and it's my longest, like, change improvement list, obviously, because what I changed in episode 1 is very minor. What I changed in episode 2 kind of stems out of that, but sort of changes the whole... you'll see when it comes out, it sort of changes all the dynamics. And then by the time episode 3 comes out, that video will be even longer because all the dynamics have once again been completely altered. But with that being said, I did really... I want to just take a few minutes here before we actually battle Dooku, because there is some puzzle solving. And if you like puzzle solving, feel free to pay attention to what I'm doing on screen. But for those that aren't as interested in it, just want to hear a little bit of Average Joe rantiness, you know, stay tuned. If you want to see the battle with Dooku, please fast forward to like the 6 minute and 30 second mark, because that's when we actually battle Dooku. But I'm going to go on a couple minute rant here about how I think Disney really freaking dropped the ball with this game, right? For those of you that are big Star Wars nerds like myself, you've likely already played a lot of the LEGO Star Wars games. And the last one I played when I was like a really young kid, I played it on the Nintendo DS, and I played it. It had episodes 1 through 6 through it, and it was great. Right at that point in time, I was probably about, I don't know, I had to be in, probably just before becoming a teenager, if not, like, it had to be before I was 13 years old, playing that game on the DS after school and things like that, taking the bus ride home from school. And I remember that game was super cool, and I thought it was really cool, and I thought it was the whole Star Wars story, because, like I said, I was about to become a teenager, and I found animation very cartoonish at the time, and never really gravitated towards it. So, for me, the Clone Wars wasn't, like, something that I would ever say, like, oh, spend any time watching this as a Star Wars fan at the time. Now, as a Star Wars fan who spent a substantial amount of time with the series, I would say the Clone Wars is, like, in large, some of the most important stuff in the series. So, like, I can't legitimately understand why, like, as a Star Wars fan, Disney acquired it, and they're like, oh, you know, the Warner Brothers label is still on the box here, but I mean, Disney owns the rights to Star Wars at this point. I'm hoping they own the rights to LEGO Star Wars. Why wouldn't you spend, I guess because you have the new trilogy, but nobody, the mass buyer doesn't care about that. Why not make a whole new, I don't even know, like 20 levels even, just based on the Clone Wars. do something with the Clone Wars. Do something with the Bad Batch. Do something with Ahsoka. Like, you have all these opportunities now available to you that Disney clearly wants to make money from. That's just like, why wouldn't you prioritize that in this setting? Like, it feels very bizarre. Like, knowing where Disney stands with the IP as a whole, and knowing that they didn't do anything Clone Wars related here, is really odd. But I mean, you have whole, you can unlock new characters, you can go to planets that aren't really developed, you can develop the story a little bit better. Like, why Disney always wants to give me the bare minimum here and just say like, oh yeah, that's good, when it's just like, this game is the same game that I played on the DS years ago with three more levels, quote unquote, that I'm not excited to play, but I want to play for the channel, just so that way we have the entirety of the game here. I don't say that to like drag that in the mud, but I felt like that needed to be covered here because it felt pretty weak. But here we go. Let's battle Dooku. Sorry for my mini rant. For those that are just tuning in now, you didn't miss much. But here we go. Got the hairbrush off of Dooku. Yeah, we're gonna battle Count Dooku, who has one of the coolest lightsabers, but
I don't think so.
It's funny, like, growing up, it was really tough to, like, acknowledge that Count Dooku was legitimately better skilled than Obi-Wan and Anakin Skywalker. Right, because we're almost led to believe, like, based off the first movie, that Anakin is space Jesus. And although he's not adequately trained, right, he still should be pretty damn good. We'd see the Death Star spinning up there. And then, Obi-Wan, I mean, yeah. We've seen him in the original trilogy. I guess we've seen Anakin Skywalker too, but I mean, different story. But, Obi-Wan trains Luke. He's a pretty solid Jedi. You know, probably like one of the best. Just like, you know, it's very bizarre. I have to use the Force to rip this off there, so that way I can climb up it using my Jedi tricks. Not a bad gimmick in a fight, but it's kind of like oddly not intuitive to get to. And like even this one, I sort of have to jump up to get to it, which sort of just causes this downward slashing motion, which is not what I want to do at all. And I get why they added this in here as like kind of filler with the Dooku battle, because the Dooku battle is pretty straightforward in the movies, but it always feels very bizarre. Okay, Dooku. I see you, man. I actually don't see you, but you know what I mean. Here he comes out of the shadows. I think I completely hosed that up, but that's fine. We're just gonna have to do that with Dooku a whole bunch of times. I don't even know what we do with this lightning, honestly. I feel like I'm kind of missing out on the goal here. I'm trying to aim it back at him, but I kind of want to do this with Obi-Wan, because like I feel like this is really Obi-Wan's fight for like up until at least the half mark, and that becomes Anakin's fight for a little bit, and then as we'll see, others get involved. But I've always felt like Obi-Wan and Count Dooku have like a much closer tie because both of their masters is Qui-Gon Jinn. Or I think Dooku was the master of Qui-Gon Jinn, actually.
Why do you flee from us, Dooku? Scared.
I think that's right. Yeah. Dooku was the first master, and then Qui-Gon Jinn, and then Obi-Wan after that. So, like, yeah, I just always felt that, like, Obi-Wan and Qui-Gon had, like, this really close... You know, obviously they had a close bond as, like, master and apprentice, but I feel like it's like, sort of transferred down. As you learn about your apprentice's apprentice. I could be mistakenly wrong, but... Sort of the vibe I got. Crash that down so that way Count Dooku comes down here.
I've had enough of this minor interruption.
Okay, Dooku, then do something about it, buddy. Okay, I was close there. It's so funny, like, yeah, Dooku's not, like, I mean, he's definitely a strong opponent, but... Okay, yeah, just switch over to Anakin and beat him. What are you doing? There you go.
Powerful you have become.
Okay, yeah, here we go. This is the main show. Yoda comes in. In the movies, man, when you see this for the first time, it blows your mind.
Powerful than any Jedi, even you. But to learn, you still have.
Yoda coming in and really tearing it up is always a joy. Of course, at this time in the movies, Anakin's already gone, so... It's a little bit more impactful. If you haven't seen the movies, Obi-Wan is currently sliced in the leg. Anakin's lost an arm. So then Yoda comes in to just sort of clean up house and save our heroes, but... I guess in the game here, they wanted to present it in a little bit more of a... appropriate manner. For kids that may be playing it. Which I respect, but don't agree. Excuse me. But that being said here, ladies and gentlemen, we are approaching the end of this episode. If you like this episode, please feel free to like, comment, subscribe. All that good stuff is greatly motivational for myself and continuing to make videos just like this now and in the near future. As I said in the episode... Prior to this episode, I am just returning home from my trip here from Dallas, Texas, so please bear in mind that my audio quality may not be the best. I'm still just kind of getting back into the groove for, like, producing these videos and having videos available for you guys to see, so I'm hoping that they're enjoyable, but, you know, when you step away from doing something like that for a week or two, you kind of lose your step a little bit, so I'm hoping that I'm right back on track here by the time that this video is coming out, and that way you guys are enjoying it. Sort of why I did that rant too at the beginning of the video too. I feel like that helped me just get back in my usual 1-2 step being pissed off at video games that I play here on the channel. But as always, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this let's play, and hope to see you back here on the next one, where we'll be returning on Mondays and Wednesdays. Of course, being that this is the end of Attack of the Clones, we'll be moving into Revenge of the Sith, which should be pretty fun stuff from this point forward. We have some serious lore stuff that's going to happen. Of course, Dooku gets away here. I believe it's, yeah, it shows it chopping off Anakin's arm. I believe in the post-credits here, Anakin and Padme are going to get married. And we're going to have a little bit of an altercation with Sidious and Count Dooku. So we're going to get a little bit of what's going on there, moving the plot forward. But as always, like I said, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please feel free to like, comment, subscribe, and we'll see you all here in the next one. Until then, peace out, Girl Scout.
Welcome home, Lord Tyrannus. You have done well.
I have good news for you, my lord. War has begun.
Excellent. Everything is going as planned.